biggest artist.
Drake will never be happy. Stop talking about some dick.
Make dozens of hits.
Man, y'all
in the hearts of millions of fans around the globe. He's always had the talent, charisma, and the support to achieve what most thought was unimaginable. Yet in recent years, his output has been forgettable and mid. Every day passing, we see more
it's
and
Drake
more.
It's Drake's birthday. What you want me to do about
quality
it?
Quality of his music. His
give him a hug. Dap him up.
Recently, just dropped a
yet
new
Drizzy
song.
Drake still prevails. How does one manage to conquer the globe with such a mediocre product? What does that say about us? Most importantly, what does it say about him? Find out on the next episode of Dragon Ball Z. Alright, was that dramatic enough for a good YouTube intro? Jesus fucking Christ.
You smell it? It's unfulfilled potential and disappointment.
Yeah, that's right. Drake dropped another just okay album. And I, for once, am not surprised in the slightest. I'm just surprised that everyone else is surprised. I must be going insane or something because I feel like I keep hearing the exact same reactions every time he drops.
Ah, if only Drake would have made it 8 songs shorter, this really could have been something.
Hey, all I'm saying is, if he just did this one thing, this could have been one of his greatest projects.
This is the best album ever!
Come on, guys, okay? It's not that bad.
Is this really your go? Alright, let me chill. Look, at this point, I'm pretty sure Drake has already discovered a formula for the mainstream rap album. Pointless subliminals, plus trendy production and features, plus excruciatingly long track list. You're gonna get the old me on this one. Spoiler alert, you're not. Empty, hollow are the words that come to mind when I think of recent.
Like, I can't ever be friends with a nigga that got this weak ass cut. Like, y'all niggas aren't, like, I wouldn't feel safe ever, bro. Like, damn, I'm not hurting. He wasn't talking about me when he did that sped shit, you dumb ass piece of shit. He wasn't talking about me. First of all, I'm not sped. Jalan is live. What you want me to do, bro? You want me to analyze her shit? Niggas really think I'm academics with this shit now, bro. Show he cooking? No, it's none about what he's saying. He could be saying the smartest shit right now. I'm talking about bro haircut, bro. It's like, is it a buzz or not?
And Drake,
do you get what I'm
what
saying?
Is even I can't. The difference I, between bro, I this don't know. And CLB. So you're gonna look me in the eyes and tell me it's not the exact same album? Go ahead, do it. Yo, how hilarious is the fact that you could have literally swapped out the titles and covers of these two?
Whoa.
And no one would notice. It's actually a trilogy. No, it's not a fucking trilogy. Okay, it's not even a duo. It's
why?
All.
Why? Yo, why does the name of the album matter? What is he? Hold on.
Titles. Do it. Yo, how hilarious is the fact that you could have literally swapped out the titles and covers of these two and no one would notice?
This is the most retarded musical take I've ever heard in my life. I'm dumb? How the fuck that's dumb? He just said you could just swap the album and name. What does that even matter, bro? He's saying they're the same album. Oh, damn, I'm retarded, bro. Oh, shit. Y'all know I'd be quick to defend Drake, bro, at all costs. So, yeah, I'm stupid, bro. I take that. I don't really give a fuck. But back to that point, shit. I mean, that's his opinion. You know, Fat D, amazing, bro. So, it's great music, so I don't really give a fuck.
It's actually a trilogy. No, it's not a fucking trilogy, okay? It's not even a duo. It's all the same shit. The same lyrics, the same gimmicky album titles, the same beats, barring Honestly Never Mind, but come on, no one really even liked that in the first place. Just a blob of nothingness. At this point, I wouldn't be surprised if Drake has a giant fucking piñata at home filled with songs recorded in 2018 that he just fucking hits every time he has to drop an album.
Whatever falls out is on the track list,
face ass. And this isn't even a secret. He's been putting out glorified playlists for like 7 years. And a lot of people think Drake is the problem, but I actually think the real problem are his fans.
The first example we have here for you today is obviously a meat muncher extraordinaire.
As you can tell, he is obviously cosplaying
as Drake.
You got
me, bro.
Look
you got me.
Pissing and shitting himself over a Party Next Door song.
You got
amazing.
Me.
The second example I have here for you today is most definitely going to be inducted into this.
Oh my God, no, Academics is an eater. You're an eater. Look at him. He giggling.
And shitting himself over a Party Next Door song. Amazing. The second example I have here for you today is most definitely going to be inducted into this dick eating hall of fame.
Fight back.
DJ I.
He moaning for a nigga to fight back?
Academics. As you can tell, even the thought of Aubrey Graham is making his toes curl and his voice crack. Truly a sight to behold.
Cause all y'all niggas daddy, that's a fact.
A grown man verbally topping off another
Yo.
Grown man. Really a testament to how far we've come as a society altogether. Thank you, DJ Academics.
All I see are low standards and
what? Bro! Why he just put me in a category just me and Ak? That is crazy as fuck. You just put me in a box with just Academics?
Yo.
The box, bro. The box finna explode, bro. That's the most craziest shit ever, bro. I ain't even doing nothing. All I did is it's like Halloween, bitch. I'm dressing up every day. I dressed up as a nigga for Halloween. Fuck you, shooter. Man, this some bullshit. That's some bullshit, bro.
Ingenuous compliments. Like, Drake is your favorite artist? That's like your favorite NBA player being Kyle Kuzma. And what I often feel coming from Drake fans...
Bro. This nigga's retarded, bro. Like, all jokes aside, so far in this video, like, no jokes, serious takeaways. He's mad because Drake is putting out fast food music. Following trends, whatever. He's not putting out meaningful projects. Okay then, bitch ass nigga. Just don't fucking listen. You're wearing Hellstar. So, like, you get what I'm saying? I don't really care about you. Now, this nigga make good videos, but he's saying nonsense. Like, you're wearing a Hellstar, though. Like his morals don't apply across the board. It just don't. Thank you for that sub. So, it's like, bro. How you getting mad at Drake? He dropped classic projects. He putting out fast food shit now. Probably just getting his streams, making his money. Are you his daddy? How you gonna live his career for him? Like just don't listen though. You're, like your ears, you're not forced to listen to shit, bitch. Like, do you get what I'm saying? Like that's retarded.
Fans is that they're more in love with his stature and popularity than the music in itself. Come on. Do you really like Drake?
Let's listen,
or do you
bro.
Like the fact that others like Drake? Ooh, that's a bar. If we're being real, for a lot of people, hip-hop is a lot more about image and likability than it is about the art. And that means as long as Drake is on top of the rap game, people will find a way to ride his nuts no matter how mediocre his music is. It's like his popularity alone breeds even more popularity. Hey, people like rooting for the winner, I guess. People are bandwagons, okay? Golden State Warriors have the most fans in the world, come on. I hate every fucking Warriors fan. But because of that mentality, Drake will never have a reason to put out a serious body of work again. He can just focus on all the shit surrounding the music, because that's what makes him the GOAT in most people's eyes anyway. And even though he isn't the GOAT of rap, okay, he isn't, come to terms, he certainly is the GOAT of popularity. And that deserves some credit in itself. It's impressive what he's done. He's like a little rap politician. He knows exactly how to move to get in the right places in the right fucking spaces. Have you ever noticed, like, every time someone catches a buzz, Drake is like,
yo, big fan, love your stuff. Collab? Question mark?
Just think about it. He did it with the UK scene on More Life. Then he did it with the Spanish collab with Bad Bunny in 2018.
Just
he did it with Drill Music in
2020,
5 Year 4 and them, and even the British
the
fucking guys. And he's doing it again today.
You
My youngins make more than you and they all stream? Your youngins? Buddy brought out Kai Cenat one time and all of a sudden he has streamer youngins. Plural. And y'all don't even understand how much of a chess move that line is. Cause now he's gonna have every popular streamer in his pocket doing free promotion. Secretly hoping they're gonna be talking to Drizzy on FaceTime.
Bro. Nigga, come on, bro. Everyone listen to Drake. If Drake dropped an album, niggas was listening regardless whether he fucking shat on streaming or not. It don't matter. That don't matter.
pocket doing free promotion.
Don't make a difference.
Secretly hoping they're gonna be talking to Drizzy on FaceTime, just like Kai does.
Hey! Come on, Gengo. Come on, Gengo.
Dude just figured out the best way to retain your popularity is to latch onto whatever else is popular and whoever else is popular. That's how you get these fake-ass relationships like Aiden Ross and Lil Uzi and Kai Cenat with fucking Drake. Oh my god, they're such good friends. Look at them. They're having so much fun. Get the fuck out of here. Come on. Come on. And if you think the fakeness stops at the relationships, you're dead wrong. Even the grudges he holds are more for show and image than anything else. Why else would he be throwing pointless subliminals at Pusha T literally 5 years after their goddamn beef ended? It's done. Like, even Drake said Pusha T won.
So it's not really much I can say better than Drake has a baby. He won. You know, he won off that.
Like, think about it. What purpose do these disses serve exactly? It's all for show. A lot of fluff and no substance.
Why is Rooftop so?
That's why when someone like Joe Budden comes along and points this out, Drake gets emotional because deep down, he knows it's true. You're not supposed to be hanging out with 20-year-olds at 37 years old. You're not supposed to be riding trends and whining about your failed relationships. This is not.
Who sets that? You're not supposed to though, bro. Who sets that standard? Other people? Who give a fuck? Who cares if he friends with a 20-year-old, 1-year-old nigga? Do that matter? Do that really matter, bro? This is irrelevant to the music.
Natural behavior for his age. This is just something that he has to uphold to retain his popularity. And Drake knows this, and he's sensitive. So how does he respond?
It's weird he hang with Lil Yachty. Are you retarded? What are you talking about, bro? It's weird he could hang with younger rappers. Why is that weird? Niggas make anything weird. Lil Yachty a bitch. Connie in here. Connie, what's up? Marry me. Connie, stop playing, bro. It's at that time. Oh no. Back to what I was saying, bro. What was I saying? Shit, I don't know. Let's keep watching, bro.
Throws out personal attacks while calling Joe Budden irrelevant.
You're not popping, so your opinion doesn't matter.
Like, come on. And everyone else is like,
oh, hardest diss of 2023. Did you see that, guys? Fuck, he ethered it.
On his nuts.
No one said that. No one said that. Yo, okay, look. Here's the good points he's made. He said that, and this may be an objective. Y'all know I want to defend Drake at every point. No dick suck. It's just like, you feel me? Like, this my childhood, bro. You feel me? Hey, look. He's right, Drake do leech on newer artists. Everyone noticed though, that's not nothing new. Drake the biggest leech in the industry. Like I told y'all the other day. The only nigga who has the most power and still try to gain power off smaller niggas. I feel like a lot of people do that, but y'all get what I'm saying. Niggas sucking Drake dick. This nigga do play, yo. You know what's funny about him though? He make a lot of good vids, bro. It's funny that he just sucking my dick this shit. He just going D1 for me. Which that's straight though, I don't give a fuck. But, because niggas gonna say whatever, but he actually made good vids though, just being objective. I don't really care what he's saying.
Oh, damn well, if that was someone else responding that way, y'all would be calling.
Oh, yeah, what I was gonna say though, the bad thing, bro. No, bro, when Drake responded, making that big ass, large ass, short constructive response for Joe Budden, no one was saying, yo, this fire, oh, got him, Drake. He looked corny, bro. Niggas recognize this. I think he giving Drake too much credit. Like, niggas been calling Drake out for his shenanigans, though, but.
This of 2023, did you see that, guys? Fuck, he ethered him.
On his nuts. Come on, you know damn well, if that was someone else responding that way, y'all would be calling him salty, and rightfully so. But because of Drake's status, the masses always tend to give him the benefit of the doubt.
That's not true.
Drake throws out bloated projects with no direction. He's just showing his versatility. All his music is samey. He's just very consistent. Pusha T objectively wins the rap beef? Who cares? He's irrelevant. We can tell Drake and his fans are on the same wavelength. Even though all of this puts money in his pocket, something just keeps bothering him. Something deep inside, hidden behind all the smoke and mirrors. The truth. And even though sometimes it moves slow and takes its time, eventually, it always comes to light. And that's why Drake will never be happy. Because he's fucking fake.
This nigga Drake watching this vid just giggling, sipping wine. Probably fucking your mama, though. You get what I'm saying? If he wanted to, if we're being honest. Like, I feel like this nigga just said, he said a bunch of bullshit in his vid. I'm just trying to fuck on Kanye. I don't really care about this shit right here. Like, but I will say, though, D1, shit, I guess I'm D1. I'm D1. Here's my thing. If you're not a Drake fan, then why does it matter that he putting out projects with no direction? How do you define good music? You get what I'm saying? Like, let's keep it a buck. Let's keep it a Benji. How you define good music? That's all subjective. I like Drake album a lot. At the end of the day, I enjoyed it. I threw on the wig. I was going crazy. I had the time of my life. One of my favorite music reaction albums ever. You feel me? That I ever did on stream. A lot of niggas hate the project. I still like it. Like, I feel like, bro, that's just so subjective for this nigga to then be like, yo, he's putting out projects that have no meaning. How you gonna tell him what do and do don't got meaning just because the lyrics similar? So all Cardi projects don't have meaning because he don't talk about none? You feel me? That's all subjective. I get what he's trying to say. Drake's not gonna be happy because he's not doing nothing. He's not changing. Oh, he's just leeching. He's just like, there's no soul behind it, no purpose, whatever. And that his fans just defend him blindlessly, like damn near yes men. But I just don't think none of that the case. You currently defending him? Defending who? Drake? Of course I am. Do I defend him on everything? No. Nigga, that Joe Budden shit was corny as hell. Where he made that paragraph, I literally was laughing with y'all niggas when he wrote 6 a.m. bars, dropping bars for no reason on his IG story in the comments. Who are those bars for? Bitch, this for the album. Drake do bullshit all the time, but I still fuck with him. We all do bullshit all the time. Yo mama is a hoe, or she a crack addict, and you not gonna defend your mom just because she do a couple bad things in her life? We all do bad things. That's an extreme example, but you get what I'm saying. It's not corny, bro. Drake do corny shit sometimes. It is what it is. Drake known as a corny nigga. It is what it is. Let's not act like Drake not corny. I don't give a fuck if he corny though. What that got to do with his music? His music not corny at all. So, hey, bro, whatever. You know, niggas got their own opinion, bro. Just have your own, bro. Find your own truth. It don't matter that much, bro. He just making a video, bro. He trying to get some content.